My name's Vivi Sierra.
And I'm Court Peterson, and welcome to SCNN. Teacher of the Year nominations are in, so go vote for your favorite on April 29th.
The PTO carnival happened, but was canceled due to weather. Luckily, it was revived the next day.
Let's check in with Kiefer Prayer and Zach Johnson for more information.
Action.
Hello, I'm Zach Johnson.
And I'm Kiefer Prayer.
Today we'll be covering grade school news.
This month, the elementary school had their PTO carnival on the 16th.
We interviewed Boone Steimel, Mia Miranda, and Tiffany Chenoweth as they are part of Art Club, and they helped out with the PTO carnival to use it as a fundraiser.
Let's go ahead and look at the interview.
Would you say the outcome of the PTO carnival was successful?
Yeah, I think it was successful. A lot of the kids that were there looked like they were having fun, so I think that's like the biggest goal.
Did the weather affect the outcome of the carnival?
I think the weather did affect the outcome because, you know, they had to move it to the day after, but it might have also helped some people that it cleared up their schedules or something.
Were you happy with the outcome of the art club portion of the PTO carnival?
Yeah, I think it was pretty successful. The kids were pretty happy, and the adults even seemed pretty happy. So I think that made it pretty successful.
Who all in art club helped with the carnival?
While I was there, it was me, Boone, Barry, Shay Amorine, Whitney Davis, Heather Julian. Then Hannah Winman and Miss Chenoweth. There might have been more, but I didn't see them.
Thank you. We also went down to the elementary school and interviewed Mrs. Kendrick and Mr. Stewart.
They were Pioneer Communications Teachers of the Year nominees.
Let's take a look at those interviews. And I'm here with Mrs. Kendrick, one of the teachers that was nominated for Teacher of the Year. I'm going to be asking her a couple questions. Mrs. Kendrick, how does it feel to be nominated as Teacher of the Year?
I'm very honored to be nominated. I'm, you know, very excited about it.
All right, second question. Do you feel like you have done anything different this year to receive the nomination?
With teaching, I feel like every year I'm trying to do something different, though. I'm always trying to better myself in education because with technology and the way that the kids are learning, I mean, I feel like with education, we always have to, you know, try to improve every year. So it's not that I've really done anything different this year, but I try to continue to, you know, always better myself as a teacher.
All right, thank you.
Thank you very much.
I'm a pretty modest guy. I don't put a lot of stock in myself, so I'm pretty honored to see that. I think what I do with hands-on work motivates the students, and just the personal interaction I have between the students makes them really enjoy being in my room.
Awesome. Thank you, sir.
Okay.
Well, that concludes the elementary news.
See you next time.
The middle school is running right through their track season. So let's check in with Devin Burns and Jeffrey Gum for more information.
I'm Devin Burns.
I'm Jeff Gum.
Welcome to the junior high news for April.
Well, now let's kick it off to track.
For the junior high track meet at home on the 1st, all the teams placed 3rd out of 3 teams.
Then on the 7th, they had another home track meet, and all the teams placed 4th out of 5, except the 7th grade girls, and they took 2nd.
We sat down with a couple of athletes and asked them a few questions about the meet.
Now let's take a look at that.
All right, hi, I'm with Peyton Peterson and Hogan Burns. What's your guys' favorite event and why?
My favorite event is long jump because it's fun and easy.
My favorite event is the mile because it's my best.
Okay. What are some of you guys' personal goals by the end of this year's track season?
My goal is to get as close to a minute in the 400 as possible.
My goal is to get to 550 in my mile and stay undefeated.
Okay, alright, that's a good goal.
Alright, thank you. We talked with Coach Chigelski to ask her some questions, and here's what she said.
Hi, I'm with track coach Mr. Chigelski. Mr. Chigelski, how many kids or trackers do you have on your team?
We have about 35 runners and throwers this year in 7th and 8th grade.
Alright, that sounds like a pretty good number. What do you expect out of the kids?
This year I expect for them to work hard during practices so that we can have some really solid performances. We're challenged a little bit by our numbers compared to other schools, and so it's not necessarily the team points we're going for, but to have those individual improvements and personal records made and broken throughout the season.
Do you think they're pretty prepared for their meets?
They will be prepared later on in the season. The problem we've had so far is that we haven't had a whole lot of practices with home meets for middle school and high school going on that have taken away from practice time.
Okay. All right, thank you. Okay. This is Mr. Chigelski.
They also have track meets on the 14th, 21st, and the 28th.
Thanks for tuning in to SCNN Junior High News. I'm Devin Burns.
I'm Jeff Gum. We'll see you next time.
High school sports have been canceled due to weather.
So let's check in with Alexis Molina and Sergio Cadero to figure out how it's affected the teams.
As you can see, multiple events have been canceled due to rain. Like two track events, two softball events, because of this water. As you can see, there's a lot of water under those seats right there.
Hello, ladies and gents, your boy Sergio Cordero.
And I'm Alex Molina. Welcome to SCNN Sports Network.
This month we'll start with track and softball games.
Yeah, our boys track team took first in the first meet, which was hosted by us, Stan County.
The girls struggled, but ended up in fifth place.
Not too bad considering there was 13 teams there, huh?
Yeah, overall it was a good meet for both boys and girls. Let's take a look at some of the track meets.
Think you may need all of mine. Hate to say, you know the love is blind. I'm about to see, I close my eyes. They can't see you in here though. Most of them need dollar signs to make every day your birthday and every night your Valentine.
But
got fifth place at the first track meet. What are your thoughts on that?
I think that for the girls, it looks like we're going to have a really good season since we're already placing up there.
All right. Since the weather was really bad, how do you think that affected your guys' performances?
I think it slowed us down a lot since the wind was about 70 miles per hour. But with us placing up there, and I can't remember what the boys did, that shows a lot of encouragement for later on during the season.
Zach, how do you feel about the boys placing first place at your guys' very first track meet?
I feel really good about it. I'm sure the other seniors do too. It's really encouraging, you know, since the boys are really young, there's a lot of freshmen, so it's really encouraging for the upcoming seasons.
What improvements do you see you guys making throughout the season?
Just working harder in practice, you know, taking like even stretches and all that more serious.
Sergio, right. What are your thoughts on the boys getting first place at the first track meet?
I said it was pretty successful. Go big, go home, you know what I'm saying? The gym. If you ain't first, you're last. Don't think about it.
All right. What do you think led to you guys getting first?
Pumping iron, working on technique, you know what I'm saying?
Softball has started off great for the girls this year. They are 5-1 so far.
Yeah, on opening day, the girls lost one and won one against the Elkhart Wildcats.
They traveled 2 days later to face the Lake and Bronx, in which they swept them 2-0.
I could honestly see them going to sub-state or even farther.
You know, we interviewed your cousin, Gracia Caro. Let's take a look.
I feel that we've been doing better this year in softball than last year. We are 3-1, and we beat Lakin in both games, and we had one tough loss against Elkhart and one win. And on Tuesday, we play against
I expect for our team to make it to state this year, since last year we had Spearville that beat that we lost in the tournament and almost finals. And this year, Spearville does not have a softball team. And Medicine Lodge lost their star pitcher, their star hitter, and a lot of place in their catcher and everyone else.
If you ever need somebody to lean on, lean on me.
Lean on it.
Lean on me. Whoa, cause I'ma make you feel so high that you could live for me.
Let me get my Morgan Freeman on. Brand new this, brand new that. Won't see no one with these sneakers on. Drunk as by 3 a.m. She came through by 4 a.m. 5 o'clock, we back in the club. And they go crazy cause they know that's him. Who that's him? Yeah, that's me. Call that boy Young Bobby Ray. The way she moves, she don't need a word. I can tell everything her body say. Now DJ, bring that record back. DJ, bring that record back. She leaned up, booty. Fat. I'm throwing that cheese like pepper jack. Lean on
if
it.
If you ever need somebody to lean on me. Lean.
This has been SCNN Sports Network. I'm Alex Molina.
And I'm Serge Cordero. And we'll dabble way out of here.
The moment we've all been waiting for.
Prom is here.
I interviewed some freshmen on their first year of prom and also seniors on their last year of prom. Let's look at some pictures from prom.
I'm with Mia Miranda and Caleb Sipes, and it's their senior year this year. How do you guys feel about prom?
I feel okay about it. I mean, it's the same as the last 3 years. So.
And your thoughts, Mia?
Fight. It's just another dance.
I'm with Tatum Heinrichs, and she's a freshman this year. How do you feel about prom?
Oh my god, it's like the biggest dream ever. I can't wait. I'm so excited. I got my dress, got my flowers. Oh my god.
How much was your dress?
Like 500?
Here right now is all we get. Skeetin' bada pop.
We also got an interview with the hypnotist Mike, who is the main attraction at this year's party after prom. Let's look at that footage.
From this moment on, anytime that I say the words rest, relax, or sleep, anytime that I say the words rest, relax, or sleep, your eyes are to immediately close, your body relaxed twice as much as the time before. You will always stay in your chairs. Anytime those seven words rest, relax, or sleep, your eyes are to immediately close, your body relax twice as much.
So I'm here with Mike the Hypnotist. He headlined at our party after prom. So Mike, what can you tell me about hypnosis?
Well, first of all, thank you so much for this interview and for allowing me to come in and do this. It's a great privilege and honor to do that. I love talking about hypnosis, as I'm sure all your listeners will find out shortly. You'll have to shut me up after a while. You know, hypnosis, it's great, and there's so many misconceptions, what people believe it to be, and, you know, and what it actually is. And when I got my start in it, I was like most people. I really didn't know what it was. And, you know, it's like anything else, you're always learning more and more about it. But the main thing is, it's completely natural, and I've been doing it now for over 10 years. I also have a clinic set up here just outside of my hometown in Duncan, Oklahoma, where we help people with pain management, help them to lose weight, overcome smoking, and other bad habits, fears, and phobias. We also do painless childbirth using hypnosis, so it's very effective in several different areas. But I guess the reason that we're being interviewed today is for the stage at the Comedy Box, which is what I did there in Johnson, Kansas. And that's for comedy purposes, but there's so many different areas of hypnosis. And a lot of people actually think that hypnosis is some sort of mind control, that, you know, the hypnotist can make people do things. And that's just simply not true. And when you really think about it, it's kind of ridiculous to think of it that way, because if you could, then, you know, it's like I say on my shows, my wife would do the dishes every night before we go to bed. You can't make people do things. There's all kinds of definitions out there, and you can Google it, you can dictionary.com it, and they're all going to have a different definition. And most all of them probably weren't written from a hypnotist. Somebody points to your leg and says, oh my gosh, you're bleeding, and you didn't even know it. But as soon as you look at it, it starts hurting. Why? Well, your attention was focused somewhere else. And that's how we can use hypnosis with childbirth. Now, I want the mother to experience everything right then and there, so she's not checked out, quote unquote, but she's no longer focused on the discomfort. And that's how we use it there.
So, Mike, when did you first get into hypnosis?
Well, actually, I've been interested in hypnosis ever since the age of about 12. I look younger than what I actually am, but when I was 12, we didn't have things like the internet and all that today, but we did have a stage hypnotist come to my school and perform for us. And really, ever since that moment, I've just loved it. And I would buy books, read up as much as I could, but then there really wasn't a whole lot around. And so I got more into magic and started doing a lot of magic up and through college. And then after I graduated from college, I got hired on at the police department in Duncan and actually met the local hypnotist. So I trained with him for about a year, I guess, and then I went off to get nationally certified in Boston, and haven't looked back since. And that was, 2005, 2006, when I actually got to experience it and actually learn hypnosis.
What is the hardest part of hypnotizing someone?
You know, the hardest part is actually explaining to the individual what hypnosis is, because there's so many misbeliefs that if somebody will tell me they're not hypnotized. And it's the funny thing to me, because I know that they are, but it's not what they believe it to be. Most people think when they're hypnotized, their eyes are going to close, they're not going to remember anything in hypnosis, and nothing can be further from the truth. And so really the hardest part about using hypnosis is explaining the process, which isn't difficult, because hypnosis is completely natural. We use it every day. You know, listening to a song on the radio even, and how it takes you back to a past memory, maybe an old boyfriend or girlfriend or a good time that you've had, it's an experience. And that's all hypnosis. It's around us all the time. So really, my job as a hypnotist is very simple. If what you do once they're hypnotized, that's the difficult part to make, whether it's change work, help somebody change a behavior. And of course, I'm just working with the people to do it. I'm not making them do anything at any time. As a matter of fact, my job as a hypnotist really is teaching the individuals, even in a stage show, how to use self-hypnosis.
Yeah, one of the things that, like you said, people tend to think that they won't remember anything. And I remember, like, last year, you came to our school for Party After Prom, and everyone was like, do you remember what happened? Were you aware of what was going on upstage? And everyone was saying, yeah, I remember it all, and it was a lot of fun. This year, though, I was talking to a friend of mine after the stage, after the performance, and he said that he didn't remember a thing, and it was like the strangest thing, because he was like that into it, is that he couldn't remember anything, that every time he closed his eyes, he was out.
Yeah, and some people, and that's really remarkable when that happens, and it depends where you go. At my show, I will always give the suggestion that they will remember everything. Now, the reason I do that is hypnosis feels amazing. It's very relaxing and soothing. And so I don't want to tell them they're not going to remember it because I want them to enjoy the relaxation. So I don't want to take that away from them. But number two is, in my show, I want them to know, the volunteers, that I'm going to take care of them. I have nothing to hide. And so, in my opinion, by telling them they're going to remember, it allows them to know in a very short amount of time that they're still in control. If they know what's going on, then they're not going to do something, you know, embarrassing or humiliating. Now, there are people out there, and called the somnambulist, anybody can learn to do it, and that's hypnosis in general. It's like learning to play an instrument, a musical instrument. The more you practice, the better you get. And so in a state of hypnosis, some people are so creative and can use their imagination so well and have laser focus that literally, just like you said, they focus so hard on the suggestion, kind of like driving down the road, they just kind of filter out everything else because they know it's no longer important in that time. And so, yeah, that doesn't surprise me because there are people that do that in pretty much every show. But for the most part, most people will remember at least bits and pieces. And your friend will probably, once he watches the video or people start talking about it, there's a good chance he'll start remembering bits and pieces of it even afterwards.
His girlfriend afterwards, and she was like, yeah, I couldn't believe you punted that dog. He was like, wait, I did what? And she took a video of it, and we had to show him that he had punted that dog after it did its business all over his car.
Now, for all the listeners out there, I think this is a good disclaimer. There was no animals injured in the production of my show. The dog was actually his shoe, even if he used it at that point. There was no live animals in the show. He punted either his shoe or it was just the air.
One of the coolest things about your show is whenever you're saying, like, you start to feel warmer out on the beach, and, like, I can feel the spotlight heat coming off. I'm actually feeling heat.
Yeah, that's exactly why. It, you know, it's just bringing your focus or your attention to something that you normally filter out. In psychology, there's a rule, and it's called 7 plus or minus 2. And basically that means that at any given time, your conscious mind can focus on 7 things. Now, give or take 2. So some people may can focus on 9, while others could only focus on 5. But give or take 2. And so what we do in hypnosis is bring your focus and your attention through a single thought, idea, or suggestion. And so just like you said, because you wasn't aware of it, but when I brought your awareness to that, all of a sudden it enhanced the experience.
Mm-hmm. Just for reference, what do you think is one of the funniest things that someone has done while you hypnotize them?
Oh, hands down, this is easy. Now, every show is unique and different. Most every show that I do, I need to think skits, because it's not the skit that makes it comical, it's the reaction of the volunteers. And everybody will react differently based on the past experiences. But there is one that stands out, and I probably shouldn't say this, but I've got your permission to say it. It is hilarious, but you really have to be there. I was performing in Branson, Missouri on the Strip in 2013, and it was a smaller show on this one particular night, but I had this elderly lady in my show, and she relaxed so well. I mean, she was just really enjoying probably the relaxation more than anything, and her false teeth fell out.
Was she aware of that when it happened?
Yeah. Now, she continued to relax. We took care of it. It was no big deal. We laughed about it afterwards. But, yeah, she just relaxed so much. And so maybe I need to go on some kind of denture cream commercial as a spokesman or something. I don't know.
Yeah, you tend to have a lot of stories during your performance of some funny things that people have done. You were at their mansion, and someone thought, oh, well, I'm not hypnotized. I can hear what he's saying. This isn't working. They went and they sat back down at their seat. You gave the command for someone to sleep, and they fell in their pie.
Yeah. It was actually at Oklahoma Governor. The chocolate pie was crazy. You know, but when you've been doing this long enough, you're going to get stories. You know, what's really fun, and I haven't told anybody this yet, actually, when I was leaving your school, I got stopped outside of Liberal, Kansas by Highway Patrol, and he asked me why I was driving so fast, and the first thing that popped into my mind was, oh my gosh, I just did this skit just a few hours ago, and so myself and the trooper began to talk about what I do, and he actually started watching the video of everybody giving excuses up on stage during the show, trying to get out of a ticket. And luckily for me, I deserved the ticket, but he was nice and did not give me a ticket. So, yeah. But when you do this long enough, you just get stories. And, you know, everybody has a story, and I love listening to other people. And I write it down, because you never know. But there's a lot of experiences in there.
Yeah. So you said that you've performed in front of governors and such. What is the largest crowd that you've performed in front of?
The largest crowd that I've ever performed in front of was actually a fundraiser. And a lot of different schools do a fundraiser for the community. I think Piedmont does a Duck Week. Duncan does Lego Week. But it's like a week-long fundraiser, basically. And what they had done, they actually had marketed my show, and everybody came to it in this town. And there was a little over 3,700 people. It was crazy. But it was a lot of fun. We had a great time. I think we had about 20 people up on stage. And, but you know one thing about it, and if you've been in the show, I honestly can't remember if he's up there or not, but if you've been in the show, you realize that after a while, you kind of just zone everybody out. And it's not about how many people's there. You're just more focused on what's going on stage. And so that's kind of what the experience was for me. I didn't really pay attention to the crowd so much as just the folks there on stage. But yeah, it was a little over, I was told, it was a little over 3,700 by the PSLs.
That's more than we have in our entire town.
Yeah, me too. And I tell people, every show, you're an actor or an actress in a play. It's not personal, and that's all we're doing is having a good time, and we're reacting or reliving everyday experiences. And so I try to keep my show as impersonal as possible. for entertainment value. Just to let them know, hey, we're here to have a good time. It kind of gives people freedom to, you know, let their imagination open up, especially when I do corporate shows. It lets them be a kid again. And so we don't make it personal to anybody. And that's actually why a lot of times I don't ask a lot of the names or focus on it.
Mm-hmm. I believe that's all I have. So I just want to thank you one more time for doing this interview with us. It's been a real pleasure. I really enjoyed talking to you some more.
You bet. And, you know, if any of your listeners are interested, they can always find me on the web at hypnosiswithmike.com. My phone number's on there. They can email me. Would love to visit with anybody that's interested if you have any questions. And most, you know, kind of a short little plug real quick, most of my business, I would say over 90%, is by referrals. And so if anybody listening knows somebody that would be interested in having a hypnosis show for their next event, let me know. And even if it doesn't work out, I'll help you any way that I can.
Mm-hmm.
Yet again, I'm going to count from one all the way to number three. When I reach number three this time, I'm going to give you a special treat, a gift that every 16-year-old would love to have. That's right, in a moment, I'm going to count from one all the way up to the number three. When I reach number three, you are going to be sitting in your very own sports car. Now, there's only two things I know for certain about this car. Number one, it is a convertible. Number two, it is fast. It can be any make, model, or color that you dream or desire. When I reach the number three, you'll sit up straight as if you were sitting in your very own sports car. When I reach the number three, you'll put your seatbelt on. You'll put the keys in the ignition and wait for further instructions. On the count of three, you'll be sitting in your very own sports car. On the count of three. One, two, three. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Sitting up straight. Put your seatbelt on, put your seatbelt on. Put the keys in the ignition. Here we go. All right, now pump the gas, pump the gas, pump the gas. That's right. Now let's put it in reverse. We're going back down out of the driveway. That's right. Cut the wheel, cut the wheel. Look over your shoulder. You're doing wonderful. Cut the wheel, cut the wheel, cut the wheel. All right, now straighten it up, straighten it up, straighten it up. Beautiful.
No. Oh. Oh. You was listening to the radio, not paying attention where you was going. That dog should not have run out in front of you. It is not your fault. It is not your fault. That little old lady should not have been walking that dog so close to the edge of the road. Oh. It's okay. She forgives you. She forgives you. Even though it's all she has, remember her late husband. He gave it to her on Valentine's Day. Oh. It's going to be okay. She says she's sorry for walking so close to the edge of the road. She's very sad.
Wait! He's breathing! He's breathing!
Oh, that puppy is alive. Your shoes have now become that puppy. Grab that puppy and put him in your lap. Get that puppy and put him in your lap. Your shoes have now become that puppy. Put your puppy in your lap. Put your puppy in the lap. Put your puppy in the lap. That's right. Oh, scratch that puppy. Scratch him on the belly. Scratch it. Oh, my goodness. Scratch that belly. Scratch that belly. Oh, my goodness. And scratch him right behind the ear. He loves that. Scratch him right behind the ear. Oh, my goodness. He loves that. Yes. And talk to him now. Talk to him in puppy talk. Talk to him. Oh, look how cute he is. Oh my goodness, he is so cute. Yes, let him lick you on the face. Pick him up, let him lick you on the face. Oh, look at that little puppy tongue. Oh my goodness, yeah. Oh, he is so cute. That dog just crapped all over your brand new clothes. Set that puppy down. Set that puppy down. I'll tell you what, let's get back in the car. Let's get back in the car. Here we go. All right, make a left turn now. Turn to the left, turn to the left. And straighten it out. You're on the highway now, 65 miles an hour. You're doing wonderful. Here comes a trucker. See if you get that truck driver to honk at you. See if you get him to honk at you. See if you get him to honk at you.
You cannot tell the truth. You're going to give me the world's greatest excuse of why I, Officer Breeze, should not give you a citation, a ticket. The more unbelievable the excuse, the more believable it becomes. I'll talk to you individually. Sir, I'm Officer Breeze with the Johnson, Kansas City Police Department. The reason I stopped you is because he's driving entirely too fast. Is there any reason for that?
No.
There's just no reason. There's just no reason. Sir, is there any reason for you to be driving so fast out here?
My 80-year-old grandma was pregnant.
Your 80-year-old grandma was pregnant and had a heart attack. Gosh. Sir, I'm Officer Breeze. The reason I stopped you is because he's driving entirely too fast. Is there any reason for that?
I'm an
new speed racer.
You're the new speed racer. Excellent. Mel, I'm Officer Breeze. The reason I stopped you is because you're driving a little bit too fast out here. Is there any reason for that?
Clouds told me the speed limit.
The clouds told you the speed limit, sure. Sir, I'm Officer Breeze. The reason I stopped you is because you're driving entirely too fast. Is there any reason for that?
I was trying to get the flux capacitor to work.
He's trying to get the capacitor to work, sure. Mel, is there any reason for you to be driving so fast out here this evening? Can't get him a wheel. Gotta go take him for a walk. I've never heard that one before. Sir, I'm Officer Breeze. The reason I stopped you is because he's driving entirely too fast out here. Is there any reason for that?
There was a bean burrito chasing
me. Talk about late night munchies. Ma'am, I'm Officer Breeze. The reason I stopped you is because he's driving entirely too fast. Is there any reason for that?
Grandpa needs a swim.
Sir, I'm Officer Breeze. The reason I stopped you is because you was driving entirely too fast. Is there any reason for that?
I had diarrhea.
Hey, when you gotta go, you got to go. Ma'am, I'm Officer Breeze. The reason I stopped you is because you was driving entirely too fast out here this evening. Is there any reason for that?
No, I had to go home because my grandma.
Because your grandma? What's going on with your grandma?
She's gonna kill me.
She's gonna kill you? Yeah, that's where I wanna go too. Ma'am, I'm Officer Breeze. Is there any reason for you to be driving so fast out here?
I was being chased by a donkey.
You was being chased by a donkey? You gotta watch out for those guys. Ma'am, I'm Officer Breeze. Is there any reason that you're going so fast out here?
I was trying to run over my ex.
I was trying to run over your ex. That explains why you kept running in reverse. Ma'am, I'm Officer Breeze. Is there any reason to be going so fast out here?
Yo no hablo japonés.
There you have it. Sir, I'm Officer Breeze. Is there any reason for you to be driving so fast out here?
I don't know. My dog Spanky's the one driving. Ask him.
Spanky the dog. Sir, I'm Officer Breeze. Is there any reason to be going so fast out here?
I've gone into labor.
Stop you is because he's driving entirely too fast. Is there any reason for that?
Because the speed limit's a suggestion.
The speed limit's just a suggestion. It's just what we thought you should go. Sir, is there any reason that you're driving so fast?
Officer, I think my speedometer is broken.
You think your speedometer is broken?
Yes.
You didn't realize how fast you was going.
It's the speedometer.
It's the speedometer. I locked you in on radar doing 107 miles an hour in a school zone, and you couldn't tell the difference? Ma'am, I'm Officer Breeze. The reason I stopped you, you're going a little bit too fast out here. Is there any reason for that?
My grandpa's water just broke.
Grandpa's water just broke. Understand. Tell him to get some Depends next time. Take care of that. Ma'am, I'm Officer Breeze. Is there any reason to be going so fast? It's not your dog. Wrong one in the speedboat. So sorry. Ma'am, I'm Officer Breeze. Is there any reason to be going so fast?
I'm sorry.
Just sorry?
My fish.
You forgot to feed your fish. Yes. Don't want him starving. Ma'am, I'm Officer Breeze. Is there any reason to be going so fast?
Well, I was just going the speed of traffic.
The speed of traffic? He's the only one out here.
Yes.
Sir, I'm Officer Breeze. Is there any reason to be going so fast?
I didn't see the speed limit sign.
You just didn't see the speed limit sign, Mel. Is there any reason to be going so fast out here this evening?
There was baby corns doing
backstands in my lawn.
There's baby corns doing backstands in your lawn.
Fair enough.
This is always the best part of every show. Everybody take a wonderful deep breath in now. Breathe in. Close your eyes. Sleep all the way down. Drifting, falling, falling, drifting. Stay in your chairs at all times. Folks, give them a round of applause. Come on. I have never heard Grandpa's water broke or walking our hamster. Those are two new ones for me. Continue to relax. You're doing wonderful. In a moment. In a moment, I'm going to count from one all the way up again to the number three. When I reach the number three, something very incredible has happened. When I reach the number three, the reason that you was driving so fast was because you were going to the movies. That's right, folks, I do this everywhere I go. Watch how quickly somebody's attitude, their mentality can change by simply a suggestion, by a song, a movie, whatever it may be. When I reach the number three, you realize that you are at the world's largest theater. Playing on that picture screen is absolutely the funniest movie you could ever imagine. Your favorite comedian, favorite actor, favorite actress, a true knee slapper. It will be hands down the funniest movie you've ever seen. And it only continues to get funnier. On the count of three, you'll sit up straight, your eyes will open, you'll look out, and notice it is the funniest movie you've ever seen in your entire life. On the count of three. One, two, and three. Here we go, ladies and gentlemen. Buddy. This is the funniest movie you could ever imagine. It gets funnier and funnier and funnier. That's right, it gets funnier and funnier and funnier. This is the funniest thing your favorite actor, favorite actress, a true knee slapper gets funnier and funnier and funnier. On the count of three, 10 times funnier. One, two, and three, 10 times funnier. Buddy. That's right, buddy. It is the funniest movie you could ever imagine. It gets funnier and funnier. The saddest movie you could ever imagine. This is based on a true story. It would even make a grown man cry. It's okay. Real men cry. It's okay. You see, it's based on a true story of a night just like tonight. She didn't do anything wrong. It was a person in the other car. First one. You never know. I want everybody to hold hands all the way across. Everybody hold hands. You see, a lot of people think that I have to say a secret word in order for them to relax, but it's actually up to them. Partner, you're going to get to hold my hand right here. This is what's going to happen. In a moment, I'm going to squeeze your hand. When I do, I want you to take a wonderful deep breath. As you exhale, I want you to allow yourself to relax twice as much as you have so far tonight. As you do that and go off into a nice, comfortable hypnotic state, you'll squeeze the person's hand next to you, and they will do the same. It'll be like a domino effect. Take a deep breath now. For everybody on stage, I want you to continue to relax. Stay in your chair where you're at now. Stay in where you're at now, but really allow yourself to let go. Continue to relax. You see, you've been given a gift tonight, whether you realize it or not. You have the gift of using the power of your subconscious mind, the other 88% that normally you never use. From this moment on, you realize that you can achieve most anything you put your mind to. Negativity no longer bothers you like it may have in the past. That's right, because you're more focused on reaching your goals. You realize that you can have anything in this world that you want. You also realize that you cannot have everything. You're more laser-focused for the dreams, goals, and desires that you choose to reach. You're very focused. Even at school, you're more focused with your grades. You find that studying has become more of a habit, and it's easier to achieve. You absorb information like never before. Tonight, or this morning, when you go to sleep, possibly you will sleep better than you ever have. In a moment, I want to count from one all the way up to the number five. When I reach the number five, and not before. When I reach the number five, you'll all sit up straight. Your eyes will open. When I reach the number five, your eyes will open. You will stand in front of your chair, and in unison, all together, you will bow to a thunderous round of applause. At that time, you will be dismissed. You'll exit to the right of the stage, just as you came up here. On the count of five, continue to relax right where you're at. I'm going to talk to the audience for a moment. Now, audience, this is where I ask for your participation. They were here for you. I know we're all tired. When I reach the number five, I do ask this. Give them the applause. Raise the roof, these guys. They were here for you, possibly a standing ovation. Keep in mind, this is not for me. It's for them. I'm going to step off stage. Now, how many by show of hands would like to sleep better at night? Show your hands if you'd like to be able to sleep better at night. Three people would. Perfect. Well, for those three people, this is what I've got. Go to my website, Hypnosis with Mike. There's a free download there. Type in your email address and it will send you the link. Banish Insomnia, my gift to you. How many people would like a copy of tonight's show? Raise your hand right now if you'd like a copy of your show. Great. For those of you, go to that website in the Contact Me section. Fill that out. Send me an email saying, hey, Mike, I would love a copy of the show. Put the date and time of this show, and I will send you a link so you can have a copy of the show. My gift to you for you having me. Thank you for having me. When I reach the number five, I do ask that you give these guys the applause they truly deserve. If we can go ahead and turn the lights back on for them so we can make sure everybody can walk off of here in a safe manner. To everybody on stage, continue to relax right where you're at. You're doing wonderful. Let's begin to count up now. When I reach the number five, again, you will stand in front of your chair with your eyes open. You'll bow to a thunderous round of applause. When I reach the number five, you'll feel refreshed, rejuvenated, full of energy, as if you've had a six-hour nap, a rest, a sleep. You'll feel better than possibly you have in a very, very long time. You'll have a sense of more self-confidence within yourself, your own abilities. When I reach the number five, again, you'll stand in front of your chair. Your eyes open, you'll bow in unison all together to a thunderous round of applause. As I count now from one, coming all the way up now, keeping your eyes closed, to the number two. That's right, feeling better with every number that I speak, every breath that you take. From two all the way up to the number three. Begin to ever so gently, ever so slightly, begin to wiggle your toes and fingers, getting all that feeling coming back to the here and now. Ever so slightly, that's right, perfect. In a moment, I'm going to count to the next number. When I do, keep your eyes closed, but just sit up straight where you're at. Keeping your eyes closed, continue to relax as you do it now. As I count from 1 to 2, 2 to 3, and all the way back up, 3, all the way up to number 4. Keeping your eyes closed, you're doing wonderful, doing excellent. Just continue to breathe. When I reach the next number, you'll stand in front of your chair with your eyes open. You'll take a bow to a thunderous round of applause. At that time, you will be dismissed on the very next count. As I count from 1 to 2, 2 to 3, 3 to 4, and 4 to 5. Give them a round of applause, guys! Come on, let them know you love them. Let them know you love them, guys! Come on!
FBLA attended State in Topeka this month. I attended to compete and also got some footage. Let's take a look at that.
As leaders, people turn to us during hardships, to guide during the obstacles, and rejoice during the successes. Throughout this conference, we will fortify our skills to help us become better leaders in our schools, communities, and in life. Kansas FBLA, together, let's connect.
District A Vice President from Stanton County, Hannah Windman.
CD while we wait for the gas man.
Chucky, me and you, one-on-one.
All right, I'll play you, just because I know I'm better than you.
You wish, Chucky.
Thank you. My name is Cade Smith. I'm from Stanton County High School, and we have 27 members.
Good afternoon, and welcome to the Kansas FBLA Awards of Excellence Program. This session is now in order. This conference has been a journey, one that has motivated us to exceed our expectations of ourselves, our peers, and our chapters through competitive events. We have had the opportunity to cast votes for our next group of state leaders and met fellow students and made connections and memories that will last a lifetime. Looking back over the conference, I know I speak for all of us when I say the obstacles we have overcome have not been done without the fellow encouragement of our chapters, advisors, friends, and families to help us become better business leaders than we were when we began this journey. As we are entering in the final stretch, we know that we have given our best and we continue to have success. Our connection does not stop here. We must take the tools that we have worked to perfect throughout the conference, whether it was a heartening message from a speaker, a skill developed in a workshop, or a triumph in a competition that has given us a new sense of confidence in ourselves and put them to use into our daily lives. This afternoon, we recognize those who will represent Kansas FBLA at the National Leadership Conference in Atlanta. Remember, success is not determined by whether or not you receive an award today. Success is gained by taking these experiences and using them to grow and become a stronger future business leader. Kansas FBLA, together we have connected.
Hannah Windman, newly elected District 8 Vice President. FBLA for sponsoring the event of Public Speaking 2. In 10th place, Damian Boland from Seaman. 9th place goes to Court Peterson, Stanton County.
For riding. Jimmy, for riding.
8th place, Maddie Tischhauser from Council Grove.
Morgan.
In 7th place, Aaron Horgum from Southeast.
That's the last one. Who's it work
6th place, Paige Kaufman from Heston.
We're riding.
5th place, Jasmine White, Anderson County.
I'll hit this guy first.
Alexander. 4th place goes to Dakota Masha.
April 30th, Forensics is going to stay up in Wichita. Next month, we'll get more information on it.
Well, that's all the time that we have for this month. Until next time, see you later, Stanton County.